Hello, everybody, and welcome to WHC Season 3, aka the anniversary season. It's been at the 1 year of two seasons and a lot of waiting. Season 3 is finally being filmed. This season's scenarios are THS3 Terrain, Blood Diamonds, and Progressive Captains. THS3 Terrain is a scenario which I don't know how to fucking explain properly, so simply it fucks up the terrain and makes struggling during the game an achievable goal after 6 years of people learning how to play. Every time you mine a diamond, you will take half part of damage to help balance out the gear,
blood diamonds.
AKA what blood diamonds is. And progressive captains will be one of the main scenarios of the season. Progressive captains is a scenario which basically the captains will get to choose a player to add to their team at the beginning of each episode, starting with episode 2. The first player on the captain's list to the last one on the captain's list. Episode 3 will be the last player on the captain list to the first player on the captain list. It'll alternate from there until we get this final episode, where all players are gone. The captains will be listed by Arctic Seagull after the config has been mentioned. And yeah, the config this season will be absorptionless to help actually make Blood Diamonds actually a useful tool. Forces will be disabled. Meetup will be episode 6. Nether alongside potions will be disabled unless they are obtained by a witch. Fire and flame will be disabled for the season, while apple rates will be at 2%. Thank you, Fanaxa and Nightmare, for hosting this season, along with Enfang, Kareb, and the White Oppressor for building a spawn. Now for players, I'll also be speccing with Judge Bacon for the season, help with everything. Now to the players, listed by Eagle, which will be the captains, and the players who are playing.
Alright, so we have TSM, a returner from Season 2. We have Enfang, a newcomer. Nixana, a returner from Season 1. Dyka, returner from Season 1. Nick, returner from Season 2. Retro, returner from Season 2. Alex, returner from Season 2. Immortal, newcomer. Westin, returner from Season 2. Nope, 1. Glaza, newcomer. Michael, returner from Season 1. Father, or Zaya, who is a newcomer. Bob Ruskin and Floss, or Kaysen, who is a newcomer. Kebeb, who is a newcomer. Zane, who is a newcomer. Brock, who has played Season 1 and Season 2. Carl, who's played Season 1 and Season 2. Pelly, a returner from Season 1. Bowfish, who's played Season 1 and 2. Plushy, a newcomer. Tay, who played Season 2. Myself, who's played Season 1 and Season 2. Espic, newcomer. And Slushy, who has played Season 1.
Okay, that's all the players. Again, thank you for Nightmare and Nightmare for hosting. And hope you all enjoy the game. How's this going?
Woo!
Yay.
It's too late, it's my turn today. Now there's no escaping a ghost. I can't shake these midnight thoughts when I'm alone. Through my brain and never let him go. So I start making plans with the noise in my head. And all these midnight thoughts when I'm alone.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Spec Died at the Start of a Game, also known as NDUHC, Season 3. It is THS3, Terrain. And, yeah. And by the way, I will just make sure that that's off, because best to be sure. Right, so. Okay, apples 32, yes. Hello guys. I am so sorry about getting you so distracted. It is rather stressful because this, THS Ray is a bit of a thing to set up. It took so much time to work out how to get this to work, but it, well, we got it to work, and it should be quite a treat. Yeah, oh lord. Okay, all right, that's done. Yeah, I just wanted to get a... I don't know if they want me to do an manual heal later on, but I'm going to assume that we're just going by the heal that happened at the start, in which case... Yeah, there are ghost spawners. I believe, except Ender Dragons and Withers, I believe. Yeah. So everything is messed up. Oh yeah. Look. See? Messed up. And also pretty annoying to get down. I'm gonna have a fun time trying to get off this plateau of annoyance and desperation and despondency and doom. I might have to do a bloody great canal work. Oh, okay, that's probably a gas spawner. That's not good. Damn it. I want to be able to see if there's a chest, but... it's going to be pretty killer. Oh, there's another spawner as well. God. I haven't played fully. Yeah, that's a gas spawner. I'm going to try and see if I can get into that one there, boy. Might be a bit dangerous. I might have to back out. Okay, that's dogs. Bread. Music discs. Okay. String. Horses are off, unfortunately, so saddle is useless, but free iron and... No chests. Run! I've already got a ghast shooting at me! Cows. That's actually really good. Bucket, iron, bread. Yeah. As people know, there is an odd glitch in THS3 terrain. Oh, that's magma creams. Ugh. That's not too fun. Oh shit. Okay. Pretty embarrassing if you ask me that you die that early. It's spawn rate's been pretty fucking high. I'm not complaining because it is going to make things more interesting to say the least. But because I already have 18 iron. I've got enough string for a bow, so actually a pretty good start. And two buckets. So. Hopefully people are a bit more careful with their PvE this game than it appears that they have been being. Because it's not fun to see people die early, especially in RRs. And he's used the wrong command. He should have let it to me. Snowman. Schneemänner. In terrible German. Server is performing fine. Yeah. It is performing just peachy. Which is pretty relieving, because terrain in this game mode is, you know, pretty wacky, and there's going to be a lot of mobs. That is for sure. I should actually say, because it really, by rights, should be off, but I don't know, they might want to have it on, which I don't think is a good idea, because, you know, ores spawn everywhere. On here. Yeah, no strip mining, that's good to hear. Yeah, pretty much. Ore rates are going to be actually, I think, vanilla 1.7 because of PHS3, which means that they're going to be a lot, actually, quite a bit lower than they would be normally in most RRs. It is literally all him black, I'm just gonna say, but like, it might sound unsympathetic, but it really is all of him, unfortunately. And it's a bit, you know, it might be a bit, sound a bit harsh, a bit mean to say that, but it really is, unfortunately, all him. Because, yeah, the server is actually running pretty well, as I said before. Oh yeah, RR time, not time left. I'm dumb. I am of the dumb. Oh god. No diamonds yet, though, which is annoying. So I would like getting chance fairly quickly. Yeah, considering in this game mode. Should be able to get, you know, stuff like enchants and diamonds quite quickly, but I appear to be having trouble. At least I have half iron and, what do you call this already? And, you know, buckets and that shit. So I have the utility stuff that I, you know, need, but I just don't have as, quite, don't have some stuff I would like. Which is frustrating. And I just realised I'm probably starting to talk like, I can't remember who it is, but, you know, really sort of in stops and starts. Oh, Iron Golem Spawner. Yeah, not going to be engaging that. No, thank you. Slushy's on 23 already. That is not good for him. Please don't die. I don't want anyone deaths. I mean, we already had a respawn. I don't want anyone to actually die for real. That would suck. Especially in, you know, a cool game mode such as this. Oh, and they all just go plowing out of the... Oh my god, Tay is on three. Please don't die in episode one. Damn it, you've got two captains. Because, yeah, that'd be very awkward to try and work out what to do if two captains die in app one. It's going to be hard enough to work out what to do if... Yeah, it's going to be awkward enough, we're just going to be going... If even one dies in episode one. Let alone two. Ah, Yuto. Yuto, that's nice. Yeah, the map is actually generated in 1.7 on a server local to the person who's doing the terrain, which in this case... Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. Well, I'm no longer Iron Man, but meh. It's just like the first season in that regard. Lose it to ores. But, yeah. The way that it works is that the world... is generated on someone else's computer external to the server, which in this case was the one and only 78 Ford, who helped me get this to be working. Thank you so very much. Seriously, if you hadn't have been able to supply me the jar, I wouldn't be able to host any future THS3 games, which I would otherwise host. Because, you know, THS3 is a fun scenario. And, really should be hosted more, but the publicly available jar does not work, unfortunately. Yeah, the way this game worked was I was sent the jar that Ford had generated by Arctic, which I then uploaded to my server. I sent the world generated by Alec. Uploaded it to my generated by Ford. Who? So let me just go back to the beginning again. Ford generates the world, which he then sends to Arctic. Arctic then sends that to me. I put the world onto my server, and dear lord, that's two baby zombies, no. Fucker, interrupting me. That's what happens if they die F1 when we have a lot of stress, because I don't know what we're going to do if they do die episode 1. And I really don't want to have to work to find out what we... what our backup plan is, because... yeah. Please. do not die in the first episode. Oh, Jesus Christ. Frickin' free baby zombies. Coming out of nowhere. Lol, 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 lol. And that is actually pretty going to give me some considerable head scratching and headaches. But it means that I do have the diamonds for enchants, and I'm actually gonna make the. No, I'm not gonna make the pick yet. But I do have the dinosaur enchants now. Only problem is, I don't have the book. I am lacking one bloody thing. Shunkian. One. And it may be a bit difficult because this map is actually quite icy, so sugarcane's going to be a bit of a rarity. The teams. Okay, end of the episode. I know it's too late, it's my turn today. No, there's no escaping.